The 5th International Scientific Conference, Exercise and Quality of Life 2019, From Active Childhood to Healthy Aging, took place in Novi Sad, Serbia, at the Faculty of Sport and Physical Education. Numerous researchers from more than 30 countries covered a wide range of topics such as quality of life research, exercise and sport science, physical education, medicine, rehabilitation, healthy aging, psychology, biomechanics and motor control. Some of the leading international experts presented cutting-edge knowledge in their area of expertise. During the conference, students, professors, researchers and scientists were given the latest scientific and professional insights, recent findings and experiences in exercise and health sciences, with a special emphasis given to the importance of lifelong exercise and quality of life.
Želim ovom prilikom da u ime pokrajinske vlade Vojvodine pozdravim sve učesnike ove sjajne međunarodne konferencije koja se u organizaciji Fakulteta za sport i fizičku kulturu održava u Novom Sadu.
Postoji samo jedna stvar koja je vredna, a to je mesto susretanja ljudi i ideja. Sama ta činjenica dovoljan je razlog da budemo zadovoljni. Nekom je važno da su to 32 zemlje, da je to veliki broj radova. Ja bih rekao različitost koja nas povezuje, koja stvara jedinstven kulturni prostor. Zapravo to je misija obrazovanja, posebno visokog obrazovanja, jer spojiti različitosti tamo gde su granice, tamo gde su interesi, ja mislim da to samo može sportska nauka i da smo uspeli u tome, ne samo u regionu, nego i šire. Ovo je konferencija koja je podržana i od strane pokrajinskog sekretarijata, Ministarstva prosvete nauke, međunarodnih organizacija, zapravo zato što smo poslali poruku koja je univerzalna. Ja mislim da je to bio i razlog zašto smo tako svesrdno podržali jedan koncept u kome se susreću ljudi i ideje, kao što sam rekao na početku.
I will talk about the assessment of physical fitness in children and adolescents. I'm coming from Palermo University and I'm honored to be here and glad to be invited on this podium. The idea is to share with the physical educators and local people that are dealing with physical activity the best standard and procedures in order to assess physical fitness in terms of health-related physical fitness, so the capacity to have a better cardiorespiratory fitness and capacity life skills, so the ability to sprint, to jump and so on.
Ova konferencija zapravo ne želi samo da usmeri pažnju na ono što je organizovano, nekakav odlazak u vežbolnicu, teretanu, nego svakodnevna fizička aktivnost. Nekada je sasvim dovoljno da prošetate svakoga dana po 30 minuta oštrim hodom, da se popnete na stepenice, prošetate psa. Čak i takve aktivnosti, dakle, unapređuju kvalitet našeg života. A moram reći da ovde o tome će govoriti istraživači iz 33 različite zemlje, sa 5 kontinenta, što je jedinstvena prilika, dakle, da čujemo specifična iskustva iz različitih zemalja. Kako oni rešavaju ovaj problem, unapređuju količinu vežbanja koju svaka osoba treba da ima.
I'm going to be talking on the health and quality of life of the elderly. And basically what we know is that people who successfully age are the people who are more active. And if the more you're active, the less distress you have, the more confidence you have, the more self-esteem you have. One of the biggest problems for the elderly is that they're very weak. They don't exercise enough and therefore they're afraid of falling. And so if you say, what is the best program for the elderly? You would say strength and balance, because they're afraid to get up, they're afraid to walk without having some sort of support nearby. And so I'm going to be talking about the different kind of programs that people should be doing for to improve their quality of life.
Predstavit ću i naš nacionalni program Živjeti zdravo, koji je sufinanciran s 85% iz Evropskog socijalnog fonda, znači što je jedan primjer dobre prakse zapravo ulaskom u Evropsku uniju, kako možete povući sredstva za multisektorske projekte, jer je to projekt koji je multisektorski, koji se provodi i u školama, i u predškolskoj životnoj dobi, i na radnim mjestima. Imamo i element koji je namijenjen isključivo tjelesnoj aktivnosti, mi ga zovemo hodanjem do zdravlja. Naročiti naglasak ću staviti na to što činimo u osnovnim školama. Razvili smo jedan model u 120 matičnih osnovnih škola, a iz ovih novaca ćemo opremiti svih 1000 područnih koje nemaju uvjete za vježbanje i za provedbu 3 sata tjelesne kulture obavezne kurikulume.
Well, I would talk about fitter kids for a healthier society. So I would talk a lot about how the physical fitness of a person is an indicator of the overall health. So how the people who have a better cardiorespiratory fitness and strength, they actually have a better physical, mental health, and even differences in the brain. Like fitter people have actually more gray matter in the brain. Fitter people have actually less chances to have a psychiatric disorder that it will end up in a disability pension in like 20, 30 years later. So in general, how by getting people in a better physical fitness through exercise, we can get people healthier in the future.
For me, this event is an enormous possibility for your country and for all those countries who happen to be involved in this event here, that they have a chance to focus on the quality of life through physical activity. And the physical activity, I mean, I have just learned that we here happen to be in the year of the young people, the youth, and one of the most important aspects in our promotion for physical activity is to reach out to the youth.